I have a very special service.
And she said, I'm at the service, my Lord.
And Agba told him, and in 8 days, you should get me 4 things. One is taste. The second one is life giver. And then the other one is a traitor. And then the fourth one is loyalty. Go around the kingdom and bring me these 4 things. Loyalty, a traitor, taste, and life giver. And then immediately Shaykh left the court. He went around looking for these things, but actually he realized that they were impossible to find. After some time, he went to his sister, and she thought for a while, but it was just a puzzle. She herself became puzzled as to what the emperor means by this. He wants you to bring him taste, bring him life giver, bring him traitor, and loyalty. So I say, the best thing to do go to be on fire. She just realized that it's not possible to solve such a puzzle. So then Hussein went to Bilbao and told him his story, how the emperor had asked for these 4 things. So then Bilbao told him, it will cost you 50,000 rupees.
You have to pay.
So then Hussein immediately ran to his place. He got the money. He said, here's the money. I want these 4 things for the emperor. So Birbal told him, okay, come tomorrow, I'll give you your stuff. Then next day he came. He gave him 2 small boxes and said, one box contains taste and the other contains life giver. But the 2 other things cannot be given. You just take these to the emperor when he asks you, you just tell him to call Bilbao, and then I will come with the other 2. So then Hussein went to the court with the 2 boxes, and then when Akbar saw only 2 things, and he asked him where the other 2, he told him they are with Bilbao. You should call him. He came with God. And he went straight to the court, found the king, and then the king was amazed. What is this man is doing? It's a dog in my court. So then he asked, where are the 2 things that you were supposed to bring? Why did you beat a dog also in my court? And then Bilbao told him, the dog is one of those things. And he began to explain how the dog represents loyalty. He told him that you give a dog a dry loaf of bread, still the dog will be grateful. Therefore, there is no creature that is loyal like a dog. And then he opened 1 box. Within it, there was water. And he explained that without water, no one can exist. Therefore, water is the life giver. And then in another box, he had salt. He told the king that without salt, food will not have any taste. Therefore, salt. And he said, the fourth thing is just there next to you, just sitting behind you. That's your son-in-law. He said, your son-in-law is a traitor. Even though you give him so many things, he keeps on complaining. He is never satisfied. So there is no traitor like a son-in-law. So So I have given him this one. So then Agbon was impressed. And then he realized that he had to bring back Yudhoyana. Actually, he just made this arrangement to impress upon his wife and his family that he was not qualified for the job because he did not understand the basic workings of material nature. So, in that way, Bilbao was again reached in his position. But because he was a Brahmin, he came from this background where he studied Vedic scriptures, he understood the basic workings of this material nature. He was able to solve many, many problems. So that's just some random. Even a materialistic fellow like Bilbo, just by understanding some random, you know, how everything is working under the Lord's dictation, how the material world is moving, producing everything, moving and non-moving under Krishna's will. He was able to solve many, many material problems in the kingdom. It's not that he was like a pure devotee who understood Tattva in regards to the absolute truth, but he just understood the workings of his material nature. So in that way, when one understands Sambandhagya, how the universe is working under Krishna, direction, how the different energies within the universe interact, and it becomes very easy to understand the problems of this world. So therefore, Sambandhagya is very, very important in this part. That's why it's given in the beginning, so that the jiva can understand how the material nature is binding us in so many ways. But when we surrender to Krishna, and then everything becomes clear. So we can stop here. Now is 8:30. We're supposed to end at 8:40. And comment? Maybe we should stop there, or should I read more verses?
That's a question.
Yeah.
And thank you very much for this question. I have a question regarding the different levels of consciousness that one goes through when it comes to Bhagavan realization. I was wondering if you could explain how it is that you go out and give someone a book on the street, and how that individual goes from getting a book, going to the temple, how that individual goes through the different stages of consciousness to reach realization as Krishna as a person.
That's a very complex question. But in a Krishna book, there's a chapter called entitled Prayers by Vedas Personified. Is Vedic Personified or Vedas Personified? Yes. There, Srila Prabhupada explains that we have different stages of consciousness. He says we live in different